हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑफ इन वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ लाइट। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन, विच इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वर्किंग ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर। मायसेल्फ योगिता दिलीप जाधव, लेक्चरर इन फिजिक्स from Science and Humanities Department of KK Vag Polytechnic Nashik. In previous video we already discussed about reflection and refraction of light. Just overlook on that topic. What do you mean by reflection of light? If we consider a reflecting surface such as mirror, a ray of light is incident on reflecting surface, then it bounces back in the same medium. This phenomenon is called as reflection of light. The ray which falls on reflecting surface is called as incident ray, and which bounces back from the reflecting surface, which is called as reflected ray. It is also found that angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection, and that is the angle made by incident ray with normal and angle made by reflected ray with normal is always same, and normal is nothing but a perpendicular drawn to the reflecting surface, that is surface of mirror. Now let us see, what do you mean by refraction of light? When a light moves from one medium to another medium, then there is change in direction of light wave. This phenomenon is called as refraction of light. As we know that when light travels in the same medium, it always moves in a straight line, but when there is change in medium, then there is change in direction of light wave, that is the refraction. Now here this ray diagram shows refraction of light. We already discussed in our previous video. Now this point is also discussed. When ray of light travels from rarer medium to the denser medium, the ray always bends towards the normal. That means in this case angle of incidence is always greater than angle of refraction, so that the refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium, which is given by Snell's law, is always greater than 1. That means refractive index of glass with respect to air, that is ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction, is always greater than 1. On the other hand, when the ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, that means it travels from glass to the air, again refraction occurs here, but the ray of light is refracted such that the angle of incidence is always less than angle of refraction. This refracted ray bends away from the normal, which is shown in this figure. Therefore, the refractive index of air with respect to glass, that means refractive index of rarer medium with respect to denser medium, is always less than 1, which is given by Snell's law, that is the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction. Now let us see, what do you mean by total internal reflection? We have to remember the previous figure, ray diagram, which shows that when ray of light travels from denser medium to the rarer medium, then the angle of refraction is always greater than angle of incidence, or angle of incidence is always less than angle of refraction. Now consider, The refraction from denser medium such as water to rarer medium such as air. Suppose the light source is kept at point A, and if from this point A it is normally incident on the surface which separates the two media, water and air, that is water-air interface. This line shows water-air interface which separates the two media, water and air. But when from the source of light which is placed at point A, light is incident in a perpendicular direction, then it moves in rarer medium, that is second medium, from first medium without any deviation. That means it travels in a straight line. But if it is inclined, which is shown in this second figure, if a ray of light AO1, which is incident at point O1 at water-air interface, then simultaneously reflection and refraction observed here. O1C, this is partially reflected ray because it moves back in the same medium, therefore it is called as partially reflected ray, and O1B, this is the refracted ray. If we increase the angle of incidence, suppose consider the second figure, AO2 is the second ray which is incident on water-air interface such that angle of incidence I dash is greater than angle of incidence I, which is at point O1. It is observed that angle of incidence increases, angle of refraction also increased. Again at point O2, there is partially reflection we also observe. But angle of incidence increases, angle of refraction also increases. If we increase the angle of incidence further, then at a particular angle of incidence, the angle of refraction is 90 degree. Now in this figure, suppose we consider a particular angle which is made by incident ray AO3 with the normal, that is denoted by letter IC here. This angle of incidence is such that angle of refraction is 90, and this angle of incidence for which angle of refraction is 90 is called as critical angle. If we increase the angle of incidence which is greater than critical angle, suppose the ray of light incident as AO4, at point O4, the angle made by incident ray with normal is greater than critical angle. And at this point, the angle of refraction, which is measured from normal to the refracted ray, is such greater than 90 degree. That means here we cannot observe any refracted ray, we observe the reflected ray. That means this ray moves back in the same medium, that is denser medium, that is water. And therefore, this ray is the totally reflected ray, and this phenomenon is called as total internal reflection. That means when a ray of light travels from denser medium, that means a medium of higher refractive index, to a medium which having lower refractive index, that is rarer medium, such that the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, then the ray moves back in the denser medium. This phenomenon is called as total internal reflection. That means if light is traveling from a medium of high refractive index, that is denser medium, to the medium of low refractive index, that is rarer medium, with angle of incidence greater than critical angle, then only reflection takes place. This is called as total internal reflection. The angle of incidence for which angle of refraction is 90, that is called as critical angle. In previous ray diagram, it is denoted by IC. From this, we can state the conditions for total internal reflection. First condition is that the light must travel from denser medium to rarer medium, and the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. Now, why we have to? Because this is the principle of working of optical fiber. Therefore, we have to study total internal reflection. Now, let us see a small demonstration which gives the clear idea of total internal reflection. Here, the glass material is taken as the denser medium. From source of light, if we incident ray normally, then it passes through the medium without any deviation. But if we increase the angle of incidence continuously, then observe that the angle of refraction also increases. We can observe the partially reflected ray in this direction also. Now, as we increase the angle of incidence continuously, angle of refraction also goes on increasing continuously. But for a particular angle of incidence, here this angle of refraction will become 90 degree, and that is about 41 to 42 degree. But if we increase the angle of incidence greater than that angle, then we observe only reflection. And this phenomenon is total internal reflection. But if we increase angle of incidence greater than critical angle, then this angle of reflection goes on increasing, but both angles, that is angle of incidence and reflection, is also same. That means here we also observe the verification of law of reflection of light. From this small demonstration, we get the idea of total internal reflection, which is the principle of working of optical fiber. Now, in case of optical fiber, the energy is transferred in the form of light. That means the optical fiber carries light energy. Therefore, it requires source of light. It is very, very small in diameter, about the diameter of our hair. There are many applications or uses of optical fiber in engineering. They are used under water cables, used in data links, used in telephone links, used for illumination and short distance transmission of images, and also waveguides in telecommunication and to carry internet or fax signals also. Let us see its construction. This represents side view and this represents the cross-sectional view of optical fiber, which consists of three coaxial regions such as core, cladding and protective jacket. Here, this is core, cladding, and this is the protective jacket, which protects the optical fiber from damage and moisture. The core diameter is in terms of micron from 15 to 125 micron, used for different purposes. Now, let us see how it works. This diagram shows the working. If from source of light is incident on optical fiber axis, then inside the core, as it having higher refractive index, this light is undergoes successive multiple total internal reflections, and light travels from one end to the other end of the optical fiber. Thank you for watching. In next video, we will see the details of optical fiber again. Happy learning, and share my video or like my video if you